In today's video, we are going to learn about profile design checks. And here with us, we have a profile. Let me just clip it. So we go to profile view style, and then we clip the vertical so as to see the profile much better. So here we have the profile. We have the curves, we have the tangents, we have crest curves, we have sag curves. So what we want to do is to check whether this meets the design control set up in the manuals. Okay, so one thing that we know is that our minimum grades in most manual, in most road design manuals, usually is a 0.5 percent. And as you can see here, this is 2.7. Ignore the sign. That is 1%. You can check it visually, but again, you can also check it through a design check setup that you set up. Another thing that we want to know is whether this alignment, our vertical alignment, meets the stopping site distance and the passing site distance. So the stopping site distance is the distance you require to brake when you see an accident or a vehicle ahead of you. You want to stop, you want to brake and stop safely. So that minimum distance, does this vertical alignment meet that? And then the passing distance is the one that you require to perceive an oncoming vehicle, and you pass it, you maneuver the passing safely. So we want to see whether this alignment, this vertical alignment or profile. So another term for the profile is usually the vertical alignment. It's also an alignment per se. So let's go to one of the presentation I made. And as you can see, stopping site distance is the distance from when the driver decides to apply the brakes until the vehicle stops. So you can see our road design speed was 50. So for different design speeds, you have different stopping site distances. And then what is important for us to know is this K value, because CO3D incorporates the K value while creating the profile. So here you can see for our design speed, the calculated K value is 6.4 and the design is 7. So they round up to 7. So what is calculated from this formula is 6.4, and then this is a round up to 7. So our key value should be 7. And this is a metric system, and then for US imperial system, you have those values here. You have those values here. Then you have another control called the passing site distance. So the distance that allows a driver to complete a normal pass while that driver can observe that there is no potential threat ahead before making the pass. So for a 50 kilometer per hour passing site distance, this is the passing site distance, 345 meters, but for the K value, the K value is 138. So keep in mind that stopping site distance is 7 while passing site distance is 138. So we want to incorporate all that into this vertical alignment so that it's able to flag to us that this alignment of yours is not safe, or it is safe. So let's see, how do we do that? We go to the settings tab, you go to the tool space, then you go to the settings tab, and under the settings tab, you have your profile, your vertical alignment, and then here you have your design checks. So you expand that and you have design checks for lines and for curves. So here you have a design check set. You have one called basic and another one called outro roads for the ANZ country kit. But now we want to create our own. We know for our lines, we need to have them at 0.5 minimum grade and probably a maximum of 10. It depends on the terrain, so that you'll need to check in your design manual and for your terrain. Is it a rolling terrain? Is it a mountainous terrain? So, but for most of them, it's usually 0.5, and that 0.5 also is there to allow for drainage. You can't have a flat road because water will be stagnant, so you need to have some grade so that water can be removed from the road. So let's do that for a line. Let's do a new check. So minimum grade, let's call it minimum grade, and then here we pick a tangent grade, and then for minimum it should be greater or equal to 0.5%. So 0.5%, if you convert it to a decimal, so it becomes 0.05 is 5%, so it becomes 0.005 here. Click OK. Then we create another one for maximum grade. And then here we call it, we take the tangent grade, and here for the maximum grade it should be less or equal to 10%, and 10% is 0.01. Yeah, 0.01. All right, then let's create for our curves. So for the curves, that's where we apply the passing site distance controls and the stopping site distance controls. So let's create a new one. Here we call it stopping. And then come here and do an expression. So our minimum K value for stopping site distance. So means minimum means should be greater or equal to 7. And remember what we saw there. So we click OK, and then we create another one for our maximum. Minimum stopping distance, passing. And then here we come and put the minimum passing site distance, and it should be greater or equal to 138, and we click OK. So now that we have both set up for the lines or the tangents and the curves, we can now come here and create a new design check set, one for our own. So we call it Academia, and then here we come and put whatever we've done. So for the minimum grade, we add it, and then we add also for the maximum grade, and then we turn to the curve, we add for the minimum the stopping site distance, and then we add for the passing site distance, and then we apply and we click OK. So right now the vertical alignment has not been assigned that design control or that design check. So how do we do that? We come and select the profile, we right click and we go to profile properties, and then we go to design criteria, and then here we assign it the design check set that we've just created, and then we click OK. So we see right now that we have some violations. You can see here the exclamation marks. So in the next video, we'll see how to correct whatever violations we've made in our design. So see you in the next video.